Good morning guys. So in this session we'll be discussing about few loop oriented question based on let's suppose for loop and very important from the placement perspective. So let's start. Okay. Let's suppose given write for n main, write n I is equal to 1, j is equal to 1 for j printf, pf means printf, percentage d, comma I, comma j, and where your I is equal to j plus plus, or say j is equal to I plus plus less than equal to 7. So you have to tell me what is the output of this code. I'm writing I is equal to 1, j is equal to 1 for I have initialized here, so no need to initialize here. So this is my testing condition. Normally in this we see modification, but since I did modification here, no need to do modification here because it is not hard and fast rule. The way you want to if you want to manipulate the for loop in any way, you can manipulate it. So there is no hard and fast rule for this. So let's suppose given this code, what is the answer? So how are you going to proceed this? So think. Okay. So what is the value of j here? So value of j is 1. So in C, you know that all positive, all negative numbers are true, only 0 is false. So if this condition is true, we'll move downwards and we'll evaluate the body of the loop. The value of j is 1 and the value of I is 1. So this becomes 1 plus plus less than equal to 7. Right, I'm putting a star here because it is post increment. It means that whenever the same variable I is encountered again in my program, I'm again repeating. Whenever the same variable I is encountered again in my program, there the value will increase to 2. But right now the value of I is just 1. So treat this as 1 less than equal to 7. So if I write 1 less than equal to 7, the condition is true or false? 1 less than equal to 7, condition is true. So in C, true means what? 1, false means 0. So if this condition is true, therefore the value of J becomes 1, right? So now, after this, go to this part. The value of J becomes 1. And since it is 1 plus plus, so whenever the same variable I is, it is encountered in here, so the value of I is getting incremented to 2. So the first output which you will find, it is 2, 1. Again, you will run a loop. What is the value of J? The J value is 1 again. So again it is what? 1 plus plus less than equal to. What is the value of I now? I is 2. So it will be 2 plus plus less than equal to 7. Again this condition is true. Therefore the value of J is 1 and the value of I will become 3. So this will be 3, 1. Similarly 3 plus plus less than equal to 7. Again it will be 4, 1. So it goes on. So let's suppose you are reaching the value 7 plus plus less than equal to 7. So 7 plus plus, meanwhile it is 7 only. The condition is true. So if this condition is true, what happens? What will the value of j? J is nothing. Again 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1. So if this is 7 plus plus, condition is true, it means the value of j is 1, but I becomes what? 8. So 8, 1. But the value of j is 1. So again you will run out, the value of j is 1, but I this time is 8. So it is 8 plus plus less than equal to 7. So this condition now becomes false. So when it becomes false, the value of j becomes what? 0. So value of j is 0, but because of this 8 plus plus, this becomes 9. Again, if you run the loop, the value of j this time is 0. 0, condition is false and you will come out of the loop. So answer is 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 8, 1 and 9, 0. Right? So let me give you one more question. Let's suppose if I write int, this f is capital, for is equal to 1. If I write for less than equal to 5 or less than equal to 7 for plus plus, right? Again if I am writing for less than equal to 5 for plus plus. Again, if I'm writing for less than equal to 4 plus plus, and I'm printf percentage d comma for, again I'm printing one more percentage d, printf comma for. Now solve this. This is capital F. This is normal formula. So now tell me what is the answer. How are you going to approach this and how are you going to solve this? Tell me, which is the part of this loop? Which is the part of this loop? Since there is no scope here, had there been a scope, these all the statements would have been the part of this loop. But since there is no scope here, it means only the next line is the part of this loop. So this loop means this, the part of this loop is this loop. Part of this loop is this loop. Part of this loop is this printf. And what about this printf? This printf is not part of any loop. It is the part of the program. So once you will come out of the loop, then you gonna print this, right? Now, let's solve this. How you gonna solve it? Tell me what is the answer. Okay, let's proceed. Now value of for is equal to 1. So here 1 less than equal to 7, condition is 2. You move downwards. The value of for is 1, so 1 less than equal to 5, condition is 2. You move forward. Right. For 1, 1 less than equal to 4, condition is 2. Then you move downward and you print the value of for, which is 1. Again, you increment. The value of for is 1 plus plus. When it will come here, the value of for is 2. 2 less than equal to 4, condition true. So it will print 2. 3 and then 4. Now when the value of 4 becomes 5, and this becomes 4 plus plus, right? So now when the value of this becomes 4 plus plus, so this has become 5 less than equal to 4, condition becomes false, right? So if the condition becomes false, and you now again going upward. So now when you're going upward, the value of 4 here is 5 right now. So this is your 5 plus plus, right? So this is a 5 plus plus. Again moving here, let take this as a 6. Okay, so now moving here, it is 5 plus plus. So what is the value of 4 here? The value of 4 is 6 here. So 6 less than equal to 5. Again the condition is false, so you go here. So it is now 6 plus plus. So when you come this side, the value of 6, since it is 6 plus plus, when you come this side, the value of 4 is now 7. So 7 less than equal to 6, condition is false, and you will come out of the loop. So once you come out of the loop, this is not a part of loop, this is part of program. So finally the value of 4 gets printed, and what is the value final value of 4? It is 7. So answer is 1 2 3 4 7, right? I'm again repeating. See, 4 less than equal to 6, initially the value of 4 is 1. So 1 less than equal to 6, condition true. Come downwards, you execute the body of this loop. What is the body of this loop? This 4 statement is the part of this loop. So you're going to execute the part of this loop. So this loop part is this. So when this condition is true, you're going to evaluate the part of the loop. So what is the value of 4 here? 1. So 1 less than equal to 5, condition true. So this condition true, the loop, the part of this loop is this loop. So again you come downward, the value of 4 is 1. 1 less than equal to 4, condition true. The condition true, the part of this loop is this printf. So again you come downward. Now you are printing the value of 4. 4 is 1. Now 4 gets incremented to 2. 2 less than equal to 4, then 3, then 4. Now when the value of 4 becomes 5, 5 less than equal to 4, condition is false. So when the condition is false, you go upward again. So here the value of 4 is 5. So it is 5 plus plus. So when you test the condition, here the value of 4 becomes 6 because it is 5 plus plus, so this becomes 6. 6 less than equal to 5, condition becomes false. So again you go upward. The value of 4 is 6 here. So when you come on this, this is 6 plus plus. So here the value of 4 is 7. 7 less than equal to 6, the condition is false. So when the condition is false, so we will come out of all the loops. And this is part of program, it is not part of the loop. So we are going to print the final value of 4, which is 7. So answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. Fine. Let me give you one more question. Never write, suppose int I, and I'm writing for printf. Let's suppose y. I'm writing scanf percentage d comma address of I. I'm writing printf o. Again, I'm writing printf u. And since it is scanf, it means you want to take the input. Let's suppose you are taking input first three. I want the answer of this code for the first three input. First input is 0, second input is 1000, and third input is 10,000. Tell me what is the answer. Okay, let's proceed. So int I, printf y. So when we compare it to the normal for loop, so we see that here it is initializing condition, then it is your testing condition, then this is your modification condition, then the body of the loop. This is not a standard thing, right? So if you want to manipulate the loop, you can manipulate the way you want. The center thing which is there inside the two semicolon, this is gonna be your testing condition. Everything depends upon this. Rest, whatever you want, you can write. Nobody going to stop you, right? So int I, first printer y, so it will print y first one. Right. Now scanf percentage d comma address of I. Now I told you that you want to take the input. I want the answer of this code just for the first three input. Now first input you are, let's suppose, putting 0. So this is 0, right? So now tell me whether this condition here is false or not. I told you in my earlier session, you go back to my previous session of for loop, where I discussed that scanf returns one argument irrespective of the fact that you are taking 0, 1000, 1 lakh, 1 crore as an input. You can take whatever number as an input, but scanf is going to return the number of argument. And since there is only one argument, so scanf will always going to return 1 in this case. Scanf returns number of arguments, printf returns number of character. So since there is only one argument, even if you are taking 0 as an input, 1000 as an input, 1 crore, 1 lakh, whatever input you want to take, scanner gonna return 1. So scanner will return 1, so this condition becomes true. So this is true, again you go down. Then so first you are evaluating this, then you are checking the testing condition, then you are evaluating the body of the loop. The next thing which is getting printed is u. So first y, then u, and after this part gets executed, so it is o. So how loop works: first, second, third, fourth, second, third, fourth, second, third, fourth, as long as the condition is true. And this initialization, it happens only once. You're not going to go to this statement again in your loop, right? So first is y, then you are taking input 0, condition is true because it is returning 1. So this is 1, condition 2, you are going down, then you are printing the u, then again up, you are printing o. Then again you are moving to this condition. Now you are taking 1000 as an input, so whatever input you are going to take doesn't affect because scanf returns 1. Again it will return 1, the condition is true, again it will print u, again it will print o, right? So again it will go to the loop, again you are taking the input, so again it will print u and o. So for the first three input, this is y, u, o, u, o, u, o, and basically it is infinite because this condition never gonna be false, right guys? So thank you so much, I hope you liked it. So if you liked it guys, please do subscribe and like my channel. Thank you so much.